Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hi, good morning viewers. How are you today? I hope you are all fine. Okay, let me introduce myself. My name is Uswatun Hasanah. I come from Alfarhan Senior High School. Here, I will tell you the story about the legend of Batu Kuung. First, I just want to say thank you to Mrs. Leli Nuria who gave opportunity for me to tell this story for you. Then, let's start and enjoy this story. Legenda Batu Kuung from the Banten province. Once upon a time in the past, there lived a village chief who was extremely arbitrary toward his people. The chief controlled the entire farm and hired his people on a very low wage. The folklore of this ruthless village chief comes from the province of Banten. It is still very popular and is still handed down in the generation to third day. For the people who disobey his orders, the village chief did not hesitate to order his men to torture. Ruling arbitrarily and cruelly made the village chief easy to amass. No amount of money has been earned from the sweat of its people. When the people were suffering from food shortages, the village had ate excessively every day. One day, an old man came to the village chief's house. The old man looked worn and looked like a beggar. The old man looked very hungry. "Hey, old beggar, get out of here quick. Get out or I'll torture you." "Hey, what's all the fuss? You are disturbing my rest."
"Chief, there's a beggar coming."
"Quickly, evict the beggar."
Seemed that there was no other choice but to leave the village chief's house. Next day, the beggar came. The village chief ordered the guards to throw him out. The third day, the grandfather came again. Except that even though the old man had so rudely stayed put.
"Guards, is the beggar won't go. Just hit him."
The guard of the evil village chief quickly beat the old man with a club, angrily snapping the guard's crutches. Even more bizarre were the guard to lie on the ground and groan in pain when the old man had not said a word.
"Hey, village chief, I confess fully here, and now for the third time you've treated me so badly. I've come here to give you a warning. Wait till tomorrow morning and see what you've done. Then everyone will suffer for his bad deed. Get it?"
Right? The village head could hardly sleep because he was afraid to hear what the old man was saying. Until finally, the village head fell asleep. In the morning,
"My body! Why can't I move it? Guards, please help!"
The physician came and went, trying to treat the village head. But none seemed to have succeeded. Dozens of physicians from other villages had been brought in, and the results were in vain.
"Village chief, look at you. It's all your own doing.
Help me, please. Help me."
"You have three conditions to meet in order to get well. First, you have to stop being cruel and stingy. If you can do it, then your paralysis will lessen a bit. Second, you have to sit on concave rock for 40 days. You can go there despite your efforts. And third, you must give your assets to the people, all the treasure you have gained in such a poor way that you have eaten what is not yours to give. If you want to eat, get the right way."
The chief followed the grandfather's word, leaving behind his vicious, violent, superior, and concave. True what the grandfather say, his paralysis lessened slightly. He was able to stand and walk toward the mountain. tiptoe with the help of a cane and wobbling. After much effort, the pillager had come upon a concave stone. The pillager had earnestly met. The blustering had obtained, the strong wind and the shivering of night in its page without giving up. On the 30th day, suddenly, near the pillager headman, a hot spring appeared. Nothing the hot springs opening, the pillager had stopped his work. He then bathed in the spring. Not long after, his paralysis completely healed. His body returned fresh, despite undergoing an asceticism for 40 days. Upon his return from the asceticism, the pillager had distributed all his wealth to the resident. All the land was given to the farmers. He only left a small pitch of rice pill to fulfill his daily needs. As he realized his mistake all this time, he did not regret falling into poverty and having to work in the fields. Hot spring is how known as Batukuwung. Batukuwung means sunken stone, as is the place where the pillager head was imprisoned. Batukuwung later became of the hot spring tourist attraction, which is located in Batukuwung village, Pada Rincang district, Serang Regency, Banten province. Okay, that all story about the legend of Batukuwung, and the moral value from this story is don't be greedy people. Okay, maybe just that from me. I ask apologize for all my mistakes. Thanks for watching. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.